Good morning, Aldersgate family.
Good morning.
And welcome to our guests. We're so glad to have you here. I hope everyone is fresh off a wonderful week. And that perhaps you took a moment or two to think about how you met Jesus on your life's path with him. Yes, thank you, Lord. Now, as for announcements, we have one more Sunday for the collection of school supplies for the children of the Riverside Station Apartments. And if you recall, I shared last week that they have packed 48 backpacks, but they have 120 children in the complex. So we would like to help them close the gap. So if you haven't dropped anything off yet, remember next week, we will be taking one of the school supplies over on Monday, August 5th. And now, Vacation Bible School is also fast approaching. Remember, it's going to run August 13, 14, and 15. And the BBS crew is also collecting school supplies. So you have a little bit longer time if you want to contribute to that effort as well. So we'll keep the bins out in the foyer through Vacation Bible School. And at the end of the service, Barbara Harrell and her, some of her little charges, I think, are going to pass out some postcards with the BBS dates on it. And we would ask you all to take, you know, one, two, three, or whatever. If you know some families that would have children that would like to participate, we would love to have you hand those cards over to those folks. And that's it for announcements. From here, is there anything that the congregation would like to add? Any announcements that I missed? Yes, Guy.
We found an earring stud that is in need of another.
Okay. There's earring studs back there. If anyone lost anything last week, you know, we'll be on the table out there.
Okay, I'll put it up.
Okay, I'll be out on the table in the foyer. Well, if there are no other announcements, I hope that you noticed on your bulletin that Pastor Tyrek's message today is titled Quality Over Quantity. And isn't it amazing that so many of us often choose the path of quantity? I mean, it's like when we decide to go to a buffet restaurant and eat, you know, and sample from all those trays of warm liver food instead of going to a nicer restaurant and enjoying, you know, smaller portions. His reference of scripture, as we notice, comes from Ecclesiastes. And if you recall, that's when Solomon, who at the time was the richest man on earth, was kind of agonizing over what was the meaning of life. So I look forward today to a message that I believe will shine the light on how we, who live under the sun, can put aside feelings of futility and hopelessness and hopeless yearning for stuff. So with that, friends, let's all bow our heads and pray for today's service and our collective week ahead. Heavenly Father, we who live under the sun, thank you for the many blessings you have provided us, from the basics like food and shelter to the tender love of family and friends. For surely every good and perfect gift comes from your hand. This morning we ask you to be with Pastor Tyrek as he examines the very human condition of questioning the meaning of life. Be with each of us in the coming week and soothe any anxiety, envy, or disappointment in our spirits. Equip us to be a blessing for someone who is in need, hurt, or even disenfranchised. We ask all this in the precious name of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
God be the glory. Hymn number 98 will sing all three stanzas. To God be the glory. What a great testimony. As our pastor said a couple of weeks ago, you can't have a testimony without having gone through a test. Amen. Stanza. Then I want to hear the sweet angelic voices of our sopranos and altos for the second stanza with everybody on the chorus. Then I want to hear the deep tenor, baritone, bass on the third stanza with everybody in the chorus. Then we're all going to sing with full voice that last stanza. I will remind you.
I'll never forget, oh, never. Jesus, I'll never forget what you've done for me. Jesus, I'll never forget how you set me free. Jesus, I'll never forget how you brought me out. Jesus, I'll never forget, oh, never.
Mercy is what I wanted from the Lord.
what I wanted.
Oh, Lord, I want
peace is what I wanted.
Oh, Lord,
peace is what I wanted.
Everything, but you still got your peace if you have God.
Yes.
Somebody could go and steal your car and crash it, but you can still have God tomorrow. So God says, if you put your trust in me and not in all these earthly things, you'll have everything that you need. And so it shifted the way that I prayed about things. I used to pray to God, God, if you just give me a little bit more money. God, if you just give me a nicer car. God, if you just give me a better paying job. But then I thought about it. And all those things can be taken away. So then I said, God, give me peace, because the peace that you give me, nobody can take it away. Amen. And God, give me joy, because the joy that you give me, the world didn't give it to me, and the world can't take it away. Yes. I mean, you have real joy. No matter what's going on in your life, you still got joy.
Amen.
And when you have peace that surpasses all understanding, the situation might not make sense, but you say, God, it is well with my soul.
Yes.
And so then I got to thinking about that thing just a little bit more. And it said a stillborn is better off than somebody who has a lot of money. And that didn't make sense to me at first. But then I thought about it. And God said that stillborn didn't have to go through all the chaos that you are going through right now. You might not have known its name. It might not have ever spoken a word. It might not have ever been able to develop its character. But it is better off than you, because he has me and you have money. He said, if you continue to put your all into these earthly things, then you really have nothing. And I got to thinking, and I read more, and it said that you can have 100 children, and if they don't bury you, then you're worse off than a stillborn. Back in those times, it was a disgrace for you to have all these children and none of them to bury you. That was disrespectful.
Right.
And so I got to thank you more. And I was like, well, if you live a long time, hey, you got something. But he says you can live a long time and still be miserable. He says you can have money and be unhappy. You can have a lot of children and still be miserable because you do not have God. All of these things, all these earthly things mean nothing if you don't have God. Because we're all going to the same place. We're all marching to the grave. Now, some of us might get there before the other one, but that doesn't mean that we're any better off than they are if we don't trust in God.
Yes.
No matter how much money you have, it's not to save you from dying.
That's right.
Some of the richest people I know, at the end of the day, we all have to be laid out, and we have to account for our deeds. No matter how much money you have, that's not going to change the way God judges you when you get to heaven. You're going to get on the scale. You have to give an account for everything that you've done. And just because you say, oh, well, I gave to this charity, and I gave to this charity, and I paid my tithes to the church. But did you have God, and did you treat God's people well?
Amen.
If you did not treat God's people well, then it doesn't really matter how much money you have, because it cannot buy your way into heaven. So we have to, as Christians, we have to get beyond a point where we ask God to bless us with more money, and bless us with a bigger house, and bless us with more cars, and bless our children so that they may see riches. And we have to start praying, God, give me peace, because peace can't go away. God, give me your joy, because joy can't go away. If I have happiness, happiness depends on the circumstance. But if you got joy, no matter what, your world can come crumbling down, and you still have joy. God, give me your spirit. God, give me your love. God, open my heart that I may love your people the way that you love them. God, if you take it all away, I'm still satisfied. And some of us, we haven't got to that point where we can say, God, if you take it all away, I'm still satisfied. God, if you don't do anything else for me, I still thank you. Because I still have my peace that surpasses all understanding. I still have joy that this word did not give to me, and it cannot take it away. God, I still have your love, and you love me beyond a shadow of a doubt. You love me more than my mother or my father could ever love me.
Yes.
And Solomon, when he wrote this thing, he said, there, this is an evil, that we can have everything and still have nothing at the same time. And you could have the nicest car, you have the most money, you can have a good job, you can have a lot of children to fill your home. But if you do not have God, then you have nothing. And it is pointless to have everything, because it's not going to save you when you have to give an account to the Lord on Judgment Day.
Amen.
He said, I am coming to judge. And no matter what, you have to give an account. So on today, do you want riches of this world that can be stolen away or burned? Or do you want peace, joy, and the love of God? Because when you have those three, nothing else really matters. Mm-hmm. Your world can come crumbling down and you say, God, I still got peace, thank you. Mm-hmm. My child not acting right, but I still got joy, God, thank you.
Amen.
I might be in the middle of a divorce right now, but God, I thank you because I still have the love of my Father in heaven.
Yes.
And you ought to get happy knowing that God loves you,
yes,
no matter what you've done, no matter what you've said, how many times you've sinned. He says, come to me who are all heavy burdened, I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you, for it is easy. And he said, what does it profit a man to gain the whole world, but to lose his soul?
Yes.
Don't lose your soul. Don't lose your ticket into heaven trying to covet the things of this earth. Mm-hmm. Because they all are going to pass away.
Yes.
And when you get to heaven, you're going to walk on gold and you're going to be like, well, what was I even worried about? When you get to heaven, he said, I have a mansion that is beyond what you could think. He said, if you, when you get here, he said, you don't have to worry about nothing else. He says, let his will be done on earth as it is in heaven. And so if you're not going to worry about anything in heaven, why do you worry about it down here?
All right.
He says, if you give me you and you take me upon you, he says, if you just trust in me, he says, I promise that you have everything you need.
Amen.
And I know that he's not a man that he should lie, so I believe him when he says that he will give me the desires of my heart if I just place it in his hands. So today, place it in God's hands and understand that no matter how much money you have, how many children you have, the car that you drive, the job that you have, the house you may live in, none of it is going to mean anything when we cross over to the life after this. It cannot save you. It cannot buy your way into heaven.
That's right.
Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not to your own understanding. But in all your ways, acknowledge him. Amen?
Amen.
This is the word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Amen. Proverbs chapter 3, verses 5 and 6. Amen. Trust and obey is in him. We'll sing now. That's the scripture the pastor just quoted. Proverbs 3, 5, 6. Trust and obey. Hymn number 467. Let's stand, please. We'll sing all four stanzas. Let's sing the first two stanzas, then the chorus, then the last two stanzas, and the chorus.
Yeah.
and maybe you don't really want to come up, you can stay where you are and we'll pray where you are. But like the scripture says, let your guiding rule be not how much, but how good. Don't worry about how much money you have or how many children you have, but worry about how good life can be for you when you put God in the midst of it. Worry about how good everything else is going to be when we get to heaven.
Yes.
Let us pray. Gracious and eternal Father, we thank you for allowing us to be in your midst one more time, oh God. God, let this word touch somebody's life, oh God. God, let them understand that it's not about this life on earth and the worldly possessions we have. God, but it's all about you. And with you, God, we cannot fail. God, that you'll never leave us, nor will you forsake us, God. You're with us until the ends of the earth, oh God. And when we see your face, oh God, and we are well done, that good and faithful servant. You've been faithful over a few things. I'm going to make you rule over many. God, give us your peace on today, God. Give us your joy on today, God, because